Hi everybody, Colin Singer here. Today's topic is going to cover Canada's immigration policies under the re-elected Liberal government for the balance of 2021 and 2022. Pretty much COVID was the highlight, as everyone knows, and it really impacted a number of programs across the board. But as we've come past a number of milestones in Canada, with vaccination rates quite high compared to other countries, Canada's borders have opened up to international travelers as of September 7. Obviously, you need to have essential requirements, namely double vaccination and a negative COVID test 72 hours, no more than 72 hours prior to your flight to Canada. Canada recently opened up its regular flight plans with India, and so that's Canada's major source country, and we're seeing a lot of people traveling to Canada for visit, for study, for work, and of course for Canadian permanent residence landings. Just a snapshot of what the policies and are in place for the next year or so. The point that jumps out quite prominently is the numbers of individuals, permanent residents, that are planned to be admitted to Canada in 2021. That, as we all know, is 401,000. But if we look at the numbers, as of the end of August, only 222,000 and a bit more have been admitted to Canada, and that leaves a shortfall of 178,000 for September, October, November, and December. It's quite a tall order, but according to the immigration minister, it's very feasible, and he plans to meet those target numbers. We're not sure how he's going to do that, but quite possibly it could come from the new programs that were opened in 2021, namely the new pathways. There were six new streams that were opened in 2021. Prominently, they were the international graduates. 40,000 were admitted, and that target level was fully met. And the second silo was the non-health care essential workers. That was 30,000 allocations. That was fully met. So we possibly could see the government allocating another number of people under those two streams to meet its numbers in part for 2021. If they were to do that, most of those people were already in Canada. A lot of those people were in Canada, and it's very possible the government might plan to conduct a draw and give a special priority to more international graduates and more non-health essential workers. If we take a look at some of the policies that they're trying to put in place for the next 12 months, of course, we can just look at this year's express entry draws. Everybody knows we didn't have an all-program draw in 2021. The number of draws, the number of ITAs issued in 2021, record numbers. But where did they come from? They came from the Canadian Experience Class and the Provincial Nominee Programs. So we have not seen any all program draws. We're still hopeful for 2021 that we would have an all program draw, which would really fuel the numbers for 2022, because in 2022, the government plans to admit 411,000 permanent residents to Canada under all programs. So it's quite feasible at this moment in time to think that all program draws will happen in the near future. It's hard to say when. There's been so far 110,000 invitations that were issued. These are record numbers, but again, they came from the CEC class and the PNP program. We can expect to see again major allocations under the six new streams that were created this year, with the bulk going to international graduates and non-health essential workers. If the government is planning to meet its target levels for 2021, they would have to admit 45,000 newcomers for each of the next 4 months, that being the next, 3 months or so. It's a tall order to meet. Quite simply, it's really a tall order. Other area where the government plans to give priority is in processing times which have been affected by COVID. There's a number of programs that were affected. The government plans to bring down processing times for these various categories. A lot of them are temporary workers, a lot of them are work permits, a lot of them are permanent residents under different streams. The government plans to significantly reduce and put its efforts on lowering processing times across the board. Processing times under global talent stream, obviously that's a priority for many IT companies, companies needing IT professionals of certain statures. The temporary foreign worker program, again, there'll be a lot of input and priority given to keeping these numbers in a fast track as possible. So getting temporary work to Canada is going to be a priority as we come out of COVID and post-COVID and into 2022. Again, travel to Canada, I've already mentioned, you're going to need your double vaccination, you're going to need a negative COVID test not more than 72 hours prior to coming to Canada. If you are planning to immigrate to Canada and you're overseas, you want to take note that the Canadian labor market is really robust. There's a number of areas in the country. Nationally, the latest figures show that the unemployment rate is 6.9%, the best rate, the lowest rate since just prior to COVID. So if we take a look at some of the hot spots in the country, you will see Quebec has an unemployment rate of 5.7% as we just come out of COVID. We can see that Manitoba is at 5.6%. We see British Columbia at 5.9%. And Ontario is on the higher end at 7.3%. A lot of these numbers don't tell the real picture. Employers need workers. There's a lot of sub-sectors where employers just can't find enough candidates to fill positions. So recruitment for Canada right now is a major challenge. And if you're serious about coming to Canada and moving to Canada on a permanent basis, you need to consider looking at this with a serious eye in two stages. You need to come to Canada, visit Canada if you can, apply for a visit visa, or if you're coming to Canada as a student, that would be great. If you're going to recruit, work with a recruiter and find employment in Canada in some of the outlying areas, this will make a very big impact, and you could very well be met with multiple job offers if you're working with the right people. Ideally, what you want to do is come and visit Canada and see for yourself the possibilities of finding employment in a number of outlying areas. I would want to share with you some of the wonderful additions to Immigration.ca. We have recently launched through SkilledWorker.com a very comprehensive employment search and consulting services. If you take a look at skilledworker.com, you will see we have excellent employment enhancing and coaching packages, which are very comprehensive. All our clients receive a full package, which comprises of three modules. Module one, of course, it's very similar to what we had before. We will help prepare your Canadian-style CV. We'll obviously prepare a cover letter going to all employers, and a very expansive employer database covering that we know to be employers hiring in your field of expertise. What's new to the table is our Module 2 and Module 3. Module 2, we will help optimize your LinkedIn profile, we will provide personal face-to-face training, and we will give you professional training courses in a number of areas related to finding employment in Canada. Once we've done Module 3 during the mandate early on, we will begin Module 3, which is a visual CV. We'll help prepare your visual CV, lot of employers don't have the time to read material. They want to see straight off the bat a very crisp CV that's visual, will work with you on doing video CVs. Of course, there will be additional courses and trainings, face-to-face training with our coaching staff, trained coaching employment advisors in the field who know what they're doing. So this package is unparalleled in the industry as we know it today. And if you're looking to come to Canada, you want to be part of those individuals who will be part of the Canadian Experience class or the PNP program. Of course, it would be ideal if you're sitting overseas and you don't have to work very hard and you just receive an invitation based on your CRS score. Well, it's moving forward with the vast numbers that are coming into Canada, with the way current policies are working, yes, there will be a number of people getting invitations who are going to be overseas and not have to access the labor market first. But for a very significant number, it's very clear that you're encouraged to come to Canada first and do this in two stages. Stage one, find employment. And stage two, get yourself sorted so you're well qualified for either the Canadian Experience class or a PNP program. Some of you will be able to access, with employment in Canada, you'll be able to access the express entry system, the straight off program draws, once they start to come to fruition, which we do expect to see. So, for Canada to reach its numbers later this year, expect some major announcement. Unfortunately, it's going to center and probably be more amenable to people who are already working in Canada. So for students who are graduates, probably we might see, maybe possibly we'll see, another allocation for foreign students who have certain credentials and who have graduated from major programs in Canada, could be working in Canada already, some of the non-healthcare essential workers. But again, if you're really serious about coming to Canada, there is a lowering, let's just say that the unemployment rate is going to fall to record levels very quickly. Talking to recruiters, there are a number of positions that will just not be filled. They can't be filled, and the only way to fill them is going overseas, and a lot of employers are going to be participating in job fairs, coming to select cities throughout the world, whether it's Europe, the Middle East, even Southeast Asia. Employers are going to be part of these roving job fairs that we know have been very successful. And so you're going to need either to be lucky to meet face to face with some of these job fairs, keep an eye out for that, or if you are in a position to come visit Canada, have the budget and put together a really structured employment search program, you'll have very good opportunity to permanently relocate here if you are successful along those lines. Well, that covers our topic for today. Follow us on social media, like our content, and keep an eye out for our next presentation, which will be very soon. Thanks for joining.